becomes that much more difficult to get a contract. But once you get one, then these clauses ought to come into operation. The system that we are envisaging at the moment, and which we have explored reasonably, is that after this is through from here, this is the fraternity who has to actually say that, yes, this is working for us. Once this is through from here, we will go to the Federation. The Federation is the Federation of Western India Cine Employees, which controls 22 unions in the film industry. So if the memorandum is approved by them, then under their jurisdiction, with their support, we will actually approach producers' bodies. We have already sent out feelers at an individual level. At various forums where I have spoken, I have mentioned to producers present there that we will be coming to you. Individually, I have spoken with them and saying that at some stage this will happen. This is the time to publicly break that ice and to sort of convey a message that yes, we are all for this, and that this contract has the backing of the writing community. So once we go to the producers' bodies, there are three of them, we'll figure out if they want to actually form some kind of a core committee, which has already been formed, or whether they want to form a new one, whatever it is. But there will be a representative body of the producers, a representative body of the writers, which is the Film Writers Association, and the moderator, the arbitrator of that particular negotiation will be the Federation. So we have Federation people here with us. I will be introducing them to you later. So this is the process that we envisage, and once it is done, it becomes like a negotiated treaty, a memorandum which is jointly signed by the representative of these two communities, producers and writers, and for a period of 2 years. If this goes through as we envisage it should, with all the wrangling and negotiations and back and forth which will happen, it will take months. But once this is done, then every single writer who is engaged by a producer in the Hindi film industry gets bound by these clauses. So pay very close attention to this. It's likely to take some more time. I had kept aside about an hour and a half. It might spill over into 2 hours or 2.5. It doesn't matter. Let's just sort of conclude this decisively. Yeah? Okay. Now, we've prepared a PowerPoint presentation, actually, which is the summary of each of these clauses. The clauses are, of course, much more elaborately sort of phrased. But Ashni is here, Rohini Vakil is here, and Atul Mankani. These are people who actually are affiliated at the moment to the Film Writers Association. So they will be there to answer all your questions. On the other hand, there will be myself, because I am the convener of the Model Contract Consultative Group. I've been working on this consistently for the last 8-9 months or so. With me, there are two other members of the Executive Committee who are also part of the Consultative Group. That is Robin Bhatt and Saket Chaudhary. I want to read out the names of the people in the Model Contract Consultative Group, which is a larger group formed by the Film Writers Association and which includes people from the senior writers from the film industry. Here we are. Okay, the people who have been meeting consistently over the last 6 months and who have endorsed this are Abbas Tayarwala, Amol Gupte, Anirudh Pathak, Anurag Kashyap, Atul Tiwari, Bhavani Ayer, Girish Damija, Imtiaz Hussain, Jaydeep Sahani, Dilis Sherwani, Javed Akhtar, Jyoti Kapoor, Kamlesh Pandey, Kannan Ayer, Meenakshi Sharma, Navdeep Singh, Ubali Chaudhary, Rajat Arora, Sanjay Sharma, Robin Bhatt, Saket Chaudhary, Samir Anjan, the lyricist, Sanjay Tandon, who also has been a consultant to the other IPR sort of society which has been formed by the lyricists, Sridhar Raghavan, Sriram Raghavan, and Vishal Bhardwaj, and myself. All these people have worked on this. So let's go with this. In case you can't understand the gist of that, as I am reminding you, these three lawyers are there to explain to you the contours or the implications of that particular thing. We will first run through all the clauses. And at the end of that, we will have a discussion. And every time you want, of course, with the click of a button, that particular clause can be put back onto the screen so that you have those things for reference. Things like schedule of payment, termination clauses, and the total fees being paid for different components of a script like story, screenplay, and dialogue. Now, in India, because sometimes these writing functions of story, of screenplay, and dialogue are done by separate individuals. So the combinations when you take only story, only screenplay, only dialogue, story, screenplay, screenplay, dialogue, story, dialogue, and a composite script. So as you can see, there are like 6 to 7 combinations. So 6 to 7 separate contracts will be made. So every time later on, after this whole thing is through, few months later, if anybody is getting into a contract with someone, they can come to the association and ask for it. Of course, it will be freely available to you, but just in case you don't have it earlier, you can always take that as a reference, and that will be the contract which hopefully will be there. Those basic clauses which will govern the larger contract that the producers might make. But these principles should not be compromised. That is the whole idea, right? So we'll run through this, and then we will have a Q&A, which should be as extensive as you want it to, provided it is pertinent. Okay, I'm chairing this session. So I will decide which questions are answered. If there's something which really is not worthy of discussion here, you will have to just trust my judgment on that. Okay, let me just call upon the stage all our panelists. Ms. Ashni Parekh, please. She's really worked hard on this, and she's the one who's drafted this. Rohini Vakil, she has been consistently helping the FWA for a long period of time. And Atul Mankane. Eventually, the FWA also intends to set up a legal sale, which will be at cost, yes, but that these lawyers, whoever, I mean, we will be speaking with them. But in principle, yes, of course, they have confirmed, but we'll have to work out the logistics and the modalities. So that legal cell also will be available for advice. So you don't have to kind of thrash around, now who do I consult, because they have thrown in a clause which I don't quite understand. While these clauses are protected, but there's a new clause which has come in. What are the implications? We will have a legal cell, hopefully soon, set up for you people to consult. Right? Okay. Saket Chaudhary, please. Robin Bhatt. I also want to invite onto the stage two people from the Federation. One is our very own Imtiaz Hussain, who is the Vice President of the FWA, but he's also a member of the Federation Committee. So he will come, and with him will be... Where is Mr. Chaturvedi? Ah, yes. Mr. Dinesh Chaturvedi, who has really been a stalwart, and he's had an enormous in-depth experience in these matters. Thank you very much, sir. Please. In the last session that we have, which is called the Way Forward, you may have questions about how this particular union, the Writers' Union, is affiliated to the Federation. What does the Federation do? Because in terms of dispute, in times of dispute, the Federation is the deciding authority. So there have been times when a dispute has come to the Film Writers Association, a dispute between a writer and a producer. And if the Writers Association, after a series of meetings, has sort of concluded that yes, indeed the producer has defaulted on this, either in terms of payment, copyright or credit, then in which case, and if the producer refuses to cooperate and pay up or give back the credit, then the whole matter goes to the Federation. The Federation also attempts to sort of confront the producer about this. If they consistently encounter non-cooperation over three notices, then the Federation has every right to declare a boycott on that film, and it has happened. Because 22 unions, including the makeup artists, the junior artists, I mean, every single person who works in the film industry is a union member of some association, of some union or the other. So they all lay down their work, there is non-cooperation, the film comes to a grinding halt. This is what the Federation can do. Okay? So we're talking about a rather effective and a rather powerful structure which is already in existence. The only unfortunate thing is that we as writers have not been able to really utilize it for various reasons which I will not go into right now. But the time for change, as we all know, is now. So we have to make sure that we utilize the existing structure to ensure that we get our whatever justice, and that this contract, if it goes through, is honored by both parties. Okay, over to you, Ashni.
Good afternoon, everyone. I have been, Anjum has kindly invited me to assist him and the association with the drafting of this agreement. As you can see, he's already become half a lawyer. What I'm going to do is run through the model contract that we've drafted based on the inputs of the committee. What you may see on screen and what I may say may be slightly different, because a lot of the points have not been covered on the presentation. So I'll start off step by step. Typically, the first clause, even before I start, while this negotiation goes on between the Writers and the Producers Association, the idea of this contract is that even when an individual, as a writer, you're going to a producer and negotiating, you would have certain ideas as to what you should be asking for and what you can negotiate. And it obviously really depends on where you are at that point of time. If you're a new writer or if you're a well-known writer, there may be some things that you may have to give up, there may be some things that you may get, but these are options that you'll always be aware of, that you have these rights and you can ask for these things. So I just start off with the whole construction of a contract. Usually it starts off with the names of the two parties.
Ashni, can I just interrupt for a small second?
Sure.
See, yeah, I forgot to mention this, that there are actually speaking two sets of clauses which you will encounter here, which Ashni will explain to you, and Rohini and Atul, that one set of clauses are the essential clauses, which are the non-negotiable clauses, on which there is no negotiation even with the producers, right? The other sets of clauses are desirable clauses. We are going through that. Ideally, what we would want is that both these should be included in every single thing. But because we need to go about it in a staggered way, you will notice that some of them are what we are going to struggle for. Some people might get, some people may not be able to get, depending upon their seniority. But these set of essential clauses, everybody gets.
Okay, so usually the contract starts off with the recital. The recital is a part of the agreement which really sets the tone for the agreement, which talks about the understanding between both the parties. After which you get into the definition clause. That it's not shown here on the presentation, but what you normally do is you set out defined terms which are repeated in the entire agreement and you define them in one place. Like for a writer contract, you'd have definitions of a story, you'd have definitions of a script, you'd have definition of what the film is. It depends. If you're, as a writer, if you're writing a film based on somebody being a specific producer and a specific person directing it, then you'd accordingly have that definition saying the film would mean this with the director being X and the producer being Y. So for whatever reason the director X changes, you still have an option to decide whether you want to render your services. So definitions always highlight a lot of the understanding in the agreement. Then we get into the services and the terms section, which is what you can see. What it usually would start off with, I'm not too sure if people know, but today when a concept is something that people discuss, there is no copyright in a concept. A concept is not something that someone can say they own. Concept is just an idea which any person can use to make a story, to make a script, a screenplay, whatever. What really is copyrightable is the treatment of the concept. It's how you treat the concept, it's how you style the characters, that's what has the copyright. So today, when you talk about a concept, it's just an idea which is not, does not have ownership. Okay, so it typically starts off, depending on what the discussion between the writer and the producer is, you're talking about the services and the terms. You basically talk about when, what is the expectation of the writer, when is he expected to deliver a story. This contract is all about a story, screenplay and script. It's not the permutations and combinations that Anjum discussed, so it's appointing one writer for all three. So you basically start off with saying what the terms are. In that you'd have the time frame. You'd also have whether the writer is appointed on an exclusive basis or a non-exclusive basis. It's very important to figure that out, because if it's an exclusive basis, then the writer cannot be working for anyone else during that period. So if you've taken him on for 6 months, most of the times writers are engaged on a non-exclusive basis, where he has a right to write other scripts, provided he gives first priority to this script. So depending on who he is and who's engaging him and the timelines, that's where the priority is decided. Then another point that's usually specified is whether he is a sole writer or is he going to have co-writers along with him. So in the contract you usually say that if the writer is somebody who wants to be the sole and exclusive writer, that's a condition to the producer that he cannot appoint another co-writer without the approval of the main writer. So unless, if they do want to appoint a co-writer, that needs to be approved by the writer, or the producer can say in the beginning that, okay, you will be there and I will have a right to appoint another writer if I so choose to. So depending, it's all about discussing these terms upfront before getting into an engagement. Then we come to points which talk about changes in the script. Obviously, whenever you're writing a script, there are a lot of drafts that keep going back and forth. So now the producer, who has commissioned the writer, considering himself as the owner, which we'll obviously talk about in the copyright section, he would have a final authority on how the script goes. So usually a writer would probably want to be mentioned in the contract that all changes would happen in consultation with the writer. It shouldn't be that the producer decides, okay, I want this change, if the writer is not willing to do it, I'll go hire another writer. It should be a consultative process, obviously with the producer having a final say. Also, a lot of writers want a term and a condition in the contract which says that whenever there are any narrations being provided for to lead cast or to a director, if the director is not already appointed, he would like to be the one narrating the story and the script to those people. So that's a clause that you may want to add in the contract which says that all narrations to these people would be done by the writer. Again, what Anjum mentioned, and which is what a lot of complaints writers have, is on the number of rewrites. It's basically, if you specify in the beginning of the contract that, okay, my cost is 9 lakhs, which is for story, screenplay, dialogue, I will be giving you not more than 3 or 4 rewrites for each stage of writing. So for a story, it would be 3 rewrites, for a screenplay, it would be 3 rewrites, and for dialogues, it would be 3. So the terms and conditions would be applicable for X number of rewrites. If you do wish to have more rewrites, then that has to be on terms mutually agreed. Not necessarily it has to be higher money, it may be, it may not be, but it's something that, so the producer is also aware of the time of the writer, and the writer is also not exploited by giving umpteen number of drafts on and on. Then there is this, this is something that after discussion with the committee felt that this is a clause that usually a lot of scripts are written and films are not made. So in order to protect the rights of the writer, the idea is when a writer writes, he wants to see that on screen. So if there is a, there could be a clause in the contract which would say, this is like an ideal clause which the Writers Association would negotiate with the Producers Association, that if the shooting of the film does not start within 2 years of approval of the final script, then the script automatically reverts back to the author, to the writer. However, if the producer wishes to extend the period, then he has to pay a certain additional price to the writer to extend it. So in effect, what we're saying is that the writer is writing the script with the condition that the film shoot commences in 2 years. If it doesn't, the rights are lost to the producer, even though the producer has paid the full price to the writer. Or an alternate clause could be that, I mean, if this does not work or this cannot be negotiated, an alternate clause could be that, yes, the producer should start shooting the film within 2 years. If he does not start shooting, then the writer has an option to buy back his script. And he can usually buy back that script at a discount, because what he has got from the producer is an understanding that the script would be made into a film, or at least start the shooting of the film within 2 years. If they don't do so, and the writer is passionate about the script and still wishes to make that into a film, he has a right to buy it back at an X price. And obviously that X price being much lower than the price at which the producer bought it. And this option would lie with the writer for maybe 1 year to buy back the script. If he cannot buy back the script, or he does not exercise his option, then the script stays with the producer. So these are 2 options. Now we come to compensation. What the committee has decided, and what Anjum was saying in terms of minimum wages or minimum salary to writers, would be 3 lakhs for every stage of writing. For story would be 3 lakhs, for screenplay would be 3 lakhs, and for dialogues would be 3 lakhs. What we're really going to now discuss is the typical breakup that we would be negotiating for vis-a-vis the producer. Okay, so on signing of the agreement, 20% of the consideration, that would be 1,80,000. This obviously, what we're discussing are the minimum costs. I mean, you can use this percentage basis on any actual amount, but here we're talking about the 9 lakh amount. So it would be 20% on signing of the agreement, 10% on approval of the story. Here what we also discussed was assuming that the story is not approved by the producer and he rejects the story or whatever, then the story belongs to the writer until such point that the producer pays this 10%. Because if you look at the full 30% of 9 lakh, I mean, if you look at 30%, the 30% comes to 2,70,000, which is not even the total cost of 3 lakhs, which was agreed for the script. So for the producer to own a story which the writer has written, which the producer has not approved, he would have to pay 30%. Then 15% of the fee, that's 1,35,000, on delivery of the first draft of screenplay. Typically in the definition clause, we would also define what a screenplay means. Similarly, in that you'll define what story means and you'll define what script means. So when you talk about these vis-a-vis the compensation, you'll know what the definitions of each of these mean. Then again, 20% on delivery of final draft of the screenplay. Again, when you talk about final draft of the screenplay, we're assuming there will be exchange of 3 or 4 of those drafts that have taken place, which is what the producer and writer have agreed to, the number of drafts exchanged. So as far as you're concerned as a writer, so long as 4 drafts are done, then that becomes a final screenplay unless you mutually agree otherwise. Then 20% on approval of final script with dialogues. Now again, usually when we write, we must specify whether the dialogues are in English or Hindi or English and Hindi. And 15%, that's the last outstanding, within 1 month of first day of shooting. Then before termination, we have statements with regard to the story, script, the treatment of the film, blah, blah, blah. But here again, the writer can probably ask for something which says that he would have a right to just make incidental comments saying that, okay, he is involved in this film and that he is writing for this, but not revealing any of the important parts of the film. Then we come to termination. Termination can happen because of a default of a writer, or it can happen because of a default of a producer. The consequences of termination for each needs to be treated differently. So when it says here, if either party decides to terminate this agreement, he must send a notice to the other stating the cause of termination and asking him to rectify any default within 15 days of the notice. So typically what a writer's default would be is that he does not comply with the terms and conditions. Again, what Anjum said, a default should not be an event that the producer is not satisfied with the work of the writer. Okay, that should not be, even if he chooses to terminate, that should not be termed as a default. He may have an option to terminate, but with the fact that he gets paid for his services, the fact that he gets credit for what he has done. So it wouldn't be construed to be a default or a breach, but it would just be construed to be a termination event. So similarly, in a document, you detail out what the defaults of a writer would be, and similarly, you detail out what the default of a producer would be. Default of a producer could be not paying you on time, with obviously a grace period. It could be not giving you a credit. It could be anything that the producer has agreed to doing for the writer under the agreement. So that's what you need to specify before you come to the consequences. Usually when you say that I have a right to terminate, you always have to send a notice in writing to the other party explaining to him what his default is and giving him an opportunity to cure that default. Because it's really not possible to go and say, okay, you have defaulted, you did this 15 days ago, I am terminating. You always have to give a cure. There may be certain events which may not which may not be a curable event. Like today, if the writer goes and under the contract, if he specifically said meant to not say anything about the script, or if he's meant to not say bad things about his cast, crew, team members, and if he goes in public and he talks, that may not be a curable event, because the damage is already done. But today, if a writer is meant to give a draft on X date and he does not give it, it's a curable event whereby he gets another 10 days grace to give it before before a producer may exercise his right to terminate.
So there it is. Now, I don't know how clear it was to all of you, but I'm just, before we start the Q&A, I'm just again talking about the two categories. One is the essential clauses. Under the essential clause, what we have is, number one, minimum wages, minimum fees. Now, this is a composite contract. As I told you, there are several combinations which will have to be made. But the underlying principle which the consultative group decided was that, number one, for a composite script, the minimum fees should be 9. Now, this is what we want. This is what we are going to bargain very hard for. Right? So, we want your approval on that one. Number two, in case there are separate elements being written by separate writers, that is story, screenplay and dialogue, then for each, after tremendous wrangling and deliberation, it was decided that it would be equal amount. So 3 minimum for story, 3 minimum for screenplay and 3 for dialogue. Right? So this is the essential clause. Number two is credit protection, which I think all of you will agree. I mean, the two primary things that we really work for is the money and the credit. So this there should be no negotiation on at all. Number third was termination. That arbitrarily the producer deciding that, okay, I don't no longer want to make...
Anjum, one thing. Please. On credits.
Yeah.
You know, when we talk about credits and we say that that's a non-negotiable clause, what's going to be more important on that is that today no producer allows you a right of injunctive relief, okay, if you don't get a credit. While we say that credit is a... No, I'm just talking about the reality of it, that, okay, if today you don't get a credit, what is the recourse?
What is the recourse?
I mean, what producers are going to tell you is they will at best try to prospectively cure that default on future prints and publicity. Okay, that's...
You can't stall the film.
You can... They will not allow you stalling the film. What you can specify is that you can claim damages, but they will never allow you injunctive relief.
You're saying this is assuming, I mean, in principle, that it was an error or a mistake, you know, or a typographical
thing. Or deliberate, whatever it may be.
There is a provision in the Copyright Act which says you have an authorship right to claim title over the film or your work. If that is the statute, if this is what is provided under the Act, and injunctive relief is also provided under the Act, we can very well opt for that option. Provided there is a constructive notice, there is an agreement between the parties which says there is a specific credit is to be provided, and if it is deliberately not provided, despite of reminders or notices, we can very well opt for such injunctive reliefs.
Yeah.
Yeah, but what usually happens is that in the agreement itself, initially the producer firstly makes you waive your moral rights, and your moral right, which is the special right to get credit, is usually what is waived. Secondly, the producer will also provide in the agreement. I mean, again, this is something you just need to be careful of when you do it, that when he says there will be no right to injunctive relief. And this usually is used a lot of times on credits. And when you say that it's not giving me credit is a breach, they will acknowledge that, I mean, not giving a writer credit is a breach, they will acknowledge that provided you are not allowed to stall the release of the film. So while what he says is completely true and notices can be passed, what they usually want in the agreement to start off with is saying that you cannot stall my film. So if you've put that in the agreement, even if the statute says this, you're agreeing otherwise. So all I'm saying is there needs to be some kind of solution on paper itself which still provides you that relief, and you can still make the producer.
Sandhya, you have a view here? We have with us another screenwriter. She's Sandhya Gokhale. She's the one who's written Paheli and a couple of other films after that. She's also a lawyer, and she has a view here.
No, Anjum, this is a question of interpretation, and I think we can go about that in courts and all that. This is, I don't think this is the right forum for it, but I completely agree with him that because it's a right given by the act in itself, it doesn't come under the purview of the moral rights. So we don't relinquish it.
One
what we can do, Anjum, is right now discuss all the rights available to an author under the Copyright Act. First, let's discuss what rights does the author really have under the Copyright Act.
Does he have this right?
Yes. Let's just.
The special right is equivalent to the moral right that's understood worldwide. And what all I'm saying is the producer makes you waive it under that contract.
That we don't want to waive.
Exactly. All I'm saying is you need to be careful assuming you waive it, assuming the producer says that your right of injunctive relief will be gone. Then what is the solution? I'm just talking about it on a practical point of view, not vis-a-vis what the law says. Because what the law says, usually, if you're a first-time writer and you're looking for, I mean, till this contract is not negotiated and you're still bargaining, I mean, negotiating this contract, there may be times when you are going to give up your moral rights, there are going to be times when you're going to give up that injunctive, that right to claim injunctive relief on the film if your credit is not given.
Yeah.
You can go to court. Today, nothing stops you from going to court.
Will the Copyright Act allow the producer to include that kind of a clause in the agreement?
Of course.
Copyright Act allows you to waive every single right.
Every single right.
Mortgage your chaddi also to them. You know?
Yeah.
So that's not the thing, you know.
There is this one clause called Section 19.4 of the Act, which specifies that if the rights that the writer has assigned to the producer are not used within 1 year, those rights automatically transfer back to the writer. So every agreement between the writer and the producer usually has a clause which says that the writer waives this right. So he gives up this right to get back his rights if the rights are not used within 1 year. So similarly, for moral rights, these are rights that producers usually want waived.
Yeah, but in this particular case, what we need to decide here, what we are proposing is that this right has to be non-negotiable, even if it involves injunctive relief.
Fair enough.
Okay. So, in which case we'll have to battle it out with them, that they have to be extra careful. It's like saying that, oh, I forgot to sign the check. I mean, that's non-negotiable. He said, oh, the check didn't reach you, I'm so sorry. I'm sorry, you can't get any recourse. We should treat it on par with that, the credit.
I think
there can't be any lapse. If there's a lapse, you hold the release and you make sure that it is put in there. So be double careful about checking the script. You don't sort of miss out Shah Rukh Khan's name, do you? I mean, you'd have a big issue on your hands. So likewise, I think we should be treated on par with the most important. So
Anjum sahab, main ye keh raha tha ki jab Copyright Act aap keh rahe hain, aisa keh raha hai ki ek saal ke baad wo rights agar producer ne nahi shuru kiya film to khud ba khud writer ke paas aa jati hain. To hum to yahan 2 saal ki baat kar rahe hain. एक साल की आप कह रहे हैं गारंटी कॉपीराइट एक्ट दे रहा है हमको, तो अगर दे रहा है तो क्या कोई ऐसा केस ऐसी बातचीत हिस्ट्री में है कि ये राइट्स एक्चुअली कभी कोई गया है कोर्ट के अंदर और उसे मिला है?
फर्स्टली टुडे द प्रॉब्लम इज दैट राइटर्स डोंट इवन नो दिस राइट एग्जिस्ट. So today when an agreement says, the producer says, you waive any and all rights which are provided in the Copyright Act, that means you've given up your right to even ask for that right. तो आप जब भी sign करते हैं तो you are giving away everything. So
आपका कहना ऐसा है कि हम model agreement जो writer की तरफ से producer body को present करें, उस agreement में ये सारी बातें लिखी हुई जो हमारे copyright act के जरिए जो हमें naturally मिली हुई वो protected हों.
Yeah.
बिल्कुल ये बात है ना कि जैसे अगर copyright act ये कह रहा है कि एक साल के बाद हमारे पास automatic right चला आता है, तो उस राइट को हम हमारा जो मॉडल एग्रीमेंट प्रोड्यूस करें उसमें नॉन नेगोशिएबल राइट करके प्रोटेक्ट करें. हम 2 साल के एग्रीमेंट में क्यों जाएं उसको? ये मतलब हाउस के सामने रखने वाली बात है. और आप तो लॉयर हैं, मैं आपका भी ओपिनियन इसमें जानना चाहूंगा.
यू कांट, नो, दिस इज अनरीजनेबल. यू सी, इट्स कंप्लीट, आई मीन, यू अप्रूव ऑफ द फाइनल ड्राफ्ट, द स्टार डजंट गिव अ डेट. आई मीन, वी नो दैट देयर आर प्रोडक्शन इंपेरेटिव्स, यू नो, व्हिच आर, सो वी, आई मीन, आई डोंट थिंक 2 years इज अनरीजनेबल. आई मीन, राइट नाउ यू हैव नथिंग, जीरो. I mean, in perpetuity it lies with him. So given that these kind of, and the Copyright Act, whenever it was written, I don't think they envisaged what star sort of situations are in Bombay today. So I think this is reasonable. We are sort of...
Anjum, you'll be surprised. Sometimes the producers also don't know about this right. I mean, I have a writer client who got out of a contract just because of this.
Yeah.
There was no waiver of 19.4.
Yeah, but Rohini, let's not sort of, gamble on the basis of their ignorance right now, you know, because all these corporates coming in, when they have the battery of the best lawyers, you know, they'll be soon coming and offering you, you know, to move away from us. So the thing here is that, I think I the committee, when we met, we decided that 2 years was a reasonable time. Is it? Because it is impractical, that is why. I mean, you can't fall back on that. It just won't go through. Even if I was the producer, it wouldn't go through. By
Anshu, under section 19.4, the provision is very clear that if the work is not utilized for 1 year, it shall return back to you, but unless contrary to the contract. So, when the association has decided after storming their brains that it should be 2 years, they must have decided this after a very long session, isn't it?
Do you know how many buffer zones that we have kept there? How many buffer zones precisely with this tactic in mind? Yeah, that certain things you do let go, you negotiate on. Yeah, but I'm saying this 2 years is not unreasonable to begin with. It also shows that you are approaching them. One second, let me finish. You are approaching them in good faith. You're not trying to beat them on the head with some copyright act. I know, but the Copyright Act doesn't envisage this current situation. Otherwise, the Copyright Act itself would get itself modified. Because you can't do that, it's impractical. It is. In a large number of cases today, it is impractical. It will just not go through. So I'm saying that we are approaching them in good faith, saying we understand that, but 2 years seems reasonable enough. So that limit is what you will have to also leave to the discretion of the negotiator. No, there's nobody eminent here. You please come straight to the point.
What does this intellectual property right organization of Geneva Convention face on it?
How does that in any way change anything here? We're talking about the current situation. No, I don't know whether we should be going into the Geneva Convention at the moment, you know. But there's an Indian Copyright Act. Oh, yeah, sure, yeah, right, absolutely. India is a signatory to also human rights, you know, treaties.
IPR, I'm a member of IPR organization. I do my registration, script registration with IPR. What IPR says on this 1 year,
go ahead, Atul, if you have an idea. Yeah.
This is
on the credit says that I retain all the credit of IPR says intellectual property right organization of the Geneva Convention. They are the signatory, all the signatory.
Agreed.
It can be the jurisdiction is the entire world.
Yeah. In the absence of a contract which specifies otherwise. Right now we are talking about governing this by unless specified otherwise in a mutually signed, yeah, of course it says that, you're right about that, except it says that unless it is specified otherwise in a mutually signed contract. So here we're talking about that this relationship under the purview of these various acts, we have to work out an individual to individual clause. On that we are saying 2 years. See, to the best of our ability, yes, whatever we could, we have. No, point absolutely taken, and it will be kept at the back of our minds. Yes, okay.
If a script is doctor more than 40%, then the credit is given to the person who has doctored it.
See, that unfortunately will be a negotiation between the producer and this so-called doctor.
Okay.
You can't stop that. We don't have a control on that. They might hire 85 co-writers. You really don't have sort of any control on that.
I think Saket wants to answer.
I just want to ask a question to Anjum Ali in terms of the contract and what this thing about doctoring. When you bring in a co-writer, is the first writer under the purview of the contract, is the first writer's permission necessary or not necessary? So you can bring in another writer without asking.
Just a minute. क्या co-writer आता है लेकिन उसे NOC लेनी पड़ेगी. NOC के बिना नहीं आ सकता. ये just एक माफ कीजिएगा, मैं फेडरेशन का जनरल सेक्रेटरी हूँ और 22 एफिलिएट्स की मदर बॉडी है हमारे. हर में जहाँ पे बीच में कोई भी आदमी आता है उसे पहले वाले आदमी की NOC लेनी पड़ती है, उसके बिना नहीं हो सकता. नहीं तो क्या है कि ये तो हम प्रोड्यूसरों के खिलाफ नहीं हैं. राइटर एक बहुत भावुक आदमी होता है, सेंटिमेंटल आदमी होता है. वो तो ऐसे ही इतने सालों से मैं देख रहा हूँ, राइटर बड़ी आसानी से मान जाता है. लेकिन सबसे बड़ी बात यह है कि अगर जो है इस तरह की बात होती रही तो एक्सप्लॉयटेशन राइटर्स का होता ही रहेगा और ज़्यादा ही होगा कि पता लगा अभी हमने इम्तियाज़ भाई को लिया है 40 बताया, अच्छा भैया रुको अब हम उनको ले लेते हैं, अब उनको लेते हैं, अब इनको ले लेते हैं, तो ये नहीं तो उसके उसके जस्ट अंजुम भाई मुझे माफ़ कीजिए मुझे इंटरप्ट करना पड़ा, तो जब वो पहले राइटर की एनओसी नहीं आती दूसरा राइटर नहीं आ सकता, ये डेड श्योर, ये मतलब ये होना चाहिए, ये है, अब आप लोग माने न माने ये आपके ऊपर है।
No, there is, I completely appreciate Mr. Chaturvedi what you said. Lekin iske andar ye hai ki why is it that the writer's position is a little different from other technicians, because here you can have about 5-6 writers as a team working on a project, whereas a cinematographer is a single one. You can't, if you hire another one, you have to displace him. A makeup man, if you hire another one, you have to displace him. Here we are not talking about displacement. Your position doesn't get displaced if he wants more help.
नहीं, मेरा मतलब क्या है कि एक राइटर है, आपने दो राइटर की टीम रखी है, ठीक है, दो राइटर हैं, जब तीसरा आएगा तो दो राइटरों से एनओसी लेनी पड़ेगी।
अगर देखो,
अगर ऐसा नहीं है प्रोड्यूसर जो है पता लगा कहीं से भी यहाँ वहां से लाके चार राइटर्स रख देगा, नहीं सर, जो राइटर बेस राइटर है उसकी परमिशन उसे लेनी पड़ेगी।
मैं समझ रहा हूँ, उसके अंदर देखो हम ये कह रहे हैं कि आपका जो पूरा जो फीस है वो प्रोटेक्टेड है, आपका क्रेडिट जो है वो प्रोटेक्टेड है, यानी उसके अंदर कोई बाधा नहीं डाल सकता है, वो नहीं हिला सकता है। यानी कि अगर उसने आपको कहा 10 लाख रुपए देगा, वो पूरे के पूरे अगर चाहे वो 50 राइटर को ले ले, आपका पैसा, आपका क्रेडिट और बाकी सारे जो हमारे क्लॉजेज है उसके अंदर जरा भी अड़चन नहीं आनी चाहिए।
अंजुम भाई यही होता है, देखिए होता क्या है कि जब हम कहते हैं भाई, प्रोड्यूसर कहता है आपका टाइटल आएगा, आप घबराइए मत, हम इनको ले रहे हैं, इनको ले रहे हैं, इनको ले रहे हैं, जब टाइटल देने की बात आती है तो वो कहता है तुमने काम क्या किया, हमने इनसे कराया, इनसे कराया, इनसे कराया, इनसे कराया, तब आप क्या करेंगे?
क्योंकि इसीलिए तो ये कॉन्ट्रैक्ट है, ये कॉन्ट्रैक्ट में लिखा है कि आप चाहे कितने भी अलग राइटर्स को, को राइटर्स को हायर कर ले, मेरा जो टॉप क्रेडिट है वो हुजूर हिलेगा नहीं, अगर वो हिलेगा तो मैं फिल्म बंद करवा दूंगा। और बिल्कुल वो चतुर्वेदी साहब आप ही के पास आएंगे ये शिकायत लेके।
देखिए, और जहां तक एक बीच की बात थी कि टाइटल नहीं देता है, अभी हमारी इम्तियाज़ भाई से बात हो रही थी, तो ये हमारे यहाँ फेडरेशन में केसेस आते रहते हैं कि साहब फाइट मास्टर का होता है, कभी कैमरामैन का होता है, कभी इसका होता है, तो ऐसा तो है नहीं कि रशपिन निकली और तुरंत ही रिलीज़ हो जाती है, रिलीज़ होने में टाइम लगता है, आपको पहले पता लग जाता है, केवल प्रिंट्स निकलने के पहले जब कभी आपको ऐसा लगे, क्योंकि हमें पता लग जाता है कि साहब प्रोड्यूसर ने टाइटल नहीं दी है, हमें बता दें, हमने करीब जो है 10-12 केसेस में हमने वहाँ तक कि प्रिंट रुकवा दी है एड लैब में कि साहब टाइटल उनका दीजिए, वरना जो है आपका जो है वो, मतलब हमारी कोई ये नहीं है, राइटर के जो टेक्नीशियन उनके अपने अधिकार हैं, जो वो काम कर रहे हैं उनका टाइटल आना चाहिए। आप जो हैं आप टाइटल उनके दे रहे हैं जिनका कोई मतलब नहीं है फिल्म से, उनके टाइटल दिए चले जा रहे हैं कि वो फाइनेंसर थे, फाइनेंसर के वो सहायक थे, उनके लिए थैंक्स, इनके लिए थैंक्स, जिस आदमी ने शुरू से, ये राइटर क्या है, राइटर तो वो नींव है जो दिखाई नहीं पड़ती लेकिन पूरी बिल्डिंग को संभाले हुए
एक,
आप ये बताइए, तो आप उस आदमी को आप जो हैं अगर कहें कि टाइटल नहीं आएगा तो ये बहुत बड़ा अन्याय है।
नहीं, मैं आई वांट टू सपोर्ट दिस इश्यू ऐसा है, एक बहुत ही बड़ी फिल्म में बहुत बड़े दो राइटरों के साथ ये हुआ है कि उनको फिल्म रिलीज पे पता चला कि साथ में प्रोड्यूसर डायरेक्टर ने अपने बेटे का नाम भी दिया हुआ है डायलॉग्स में और स्क्रीन प्ले में, और आज और जब कुछ नहीं हो सका उसके बारे में, देयर आर सर्टेन पीपल हु नो दिस इंसिडेंट। पॉइंट इज द राइटर एनओसी लेनी पड़ेगी कोई भी नाम, कोई भी दूसरा राइटर लेने से पहले। इट इज नॉट रबिश, यू माइट थिंक इट इज रबिश, I am trying to protect, not me. I am trying to protect new writers. उनसे 50 सीन लिखवाएंगे, कहते आप चलते बढ़िए, मैं रॉबिन बर्ड से बाकी के लिखवा लूंगा। Yes, every writer has his right over his work.
Absolutely. Where am I saying no? What is it in this contract that in any way opposes what you're saying? It doesn't, Robin. This is what we've gone over.
Union protects you.
It does. Yeah, but the point is, see, I'm saying look at it the other way around. You're a producer, suppose. Yeah, can we just please discuss this? I need to take you into confidence on this one. Yeah? That if you are the producer, and it genuinely does happen that I am not, you hired me as a writer with this 9 lakh of rupees. I am not able to give you by the end of the fourth draft the quality which you do need, genuinely so. In which case do you have the recourse to at least get somebody else on board, provided every, all my rights are protected. So all my rights are protected anyway. I don't need to give an NOC. It's protected.
That's Shama Zaidi.
Spectrum has changed. Now, with the money coming in now, a film is not, the actor is not there. I'm writing a film which we're trying to get Hollywood actors. Now, the script, up to a certain point, maybe the film will not get made, but to point X, I've signed a contract where I get my full amount. Now, the financer, who is from outside India, he said, we don't know whether Indians can make a Hollywood type of film, so I want to bring in a script doctor from Hollywood. Do you agree? And I said, yes, I agree, if I get the final edit. So the script doctor in Hollywood rewrote this script, and I redid whatever I liked or what he did, and chucked out everything else. But I had that as a condition before I agreed for a doctoring of my script. Apart from that, because the amount of money that's involved, they want to be sure. Before even the script has not been sent to any actor, they want a perfect script in which everybody is happy. Only then the script is sent to an actor, and then the further thing happens. So there are many stages. Then there's another thing called a script consultant, who only points out the faults in your script. Ki is scene mein aapne ye kaha hai, iske 5 scene baad aapne ulti baat kahi hai, ye jhol hai, ye kyun nahi hai. They also charge money, and they get a credit as script consultant. So there are many stages. So I think we should stop thinking of what the kind of thing we had earlier, jaise ye keh rahe hain ki apne bhanje bhatije beton se likhwaya hai. That is what you're trying to make this contract for. But there are other aspects which I think you should look into. And a script doctor is not what you think it is. You get your full credit, you get your money, and if the film is made, you'll get extra money. If the film is not made, you still get your money. And the other thing is that there are other aspects like travel and research. Now, who pays for that?
No, that's included in that. I mean, we didn't specify that here because we thought it was not necessary.
No,
but it's,
that's
no,
something
it
that's usually
it is,
a separate
Shama,
clause.
Let me just answer okay. You. It's there. It's there. Clearly, there's an elaborate paragraph which says that every out-of-pocket expense, every research, books, blah, 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 provided you take the earlier approval of the director and or producer, whatever, that the certain system is there.
Even now, the rights to, if you're going to make your story based, I mean, your script based on a book, the rights to buy the book, everything is on the producer's account, your accommodation, your travel, it's all specified in the
contract. It's all specified. The other thing also, see, you need to remember one thing, and Robin, I'm again drawing your attention to this, is that this is an across-the-board basic contract for a person who may have never ever written in his life, but who does get a chance to do so. So I'm saying, for individuals, like I will share with you that I'm writing for Prakash Jha, who's the director and the producer. In my contract, it actually specifies this, that you will not hire anyone unless I give a written NOC. Because I didn't want it, I said, this is the only basis on which I can work, take it or leave it. He said, I have no issues with that at all, because we have a reasonable, whatever, understanding, blah, blah, blah. So individuals can do that. There is no harm. This contract doesn't stop you from going further and specifying that I don't want to see the face of the producer ever in my life, but that should be contract. You can do that. People in Hollywood do that. Hear me out. So this is across the board.
यस आप एक 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 ये एक पॉइंट है जहाँ पे राइटर्स एनओसी देने में हिचकिचाते हैं कि पैसा मिलेगा कि नहीं मिलेगा तो मैं आपको ये साफ कर दूं कि एनओसी राइटर से ली जाती है या तो एसोसिएशन की उसमें जो है प्रोड्यूसर पैसे देता है या अगर बात बढ़ती है तो फेडरेशन में फेडरेशन का हरदम ये रहा है कि फेडरेशन जो है वो पैसे जो है फेडरेशन में जमा हो जाते हैं और राइटर से जो एनओसी आती है वो एक्सचेंज हो जाती है एनओसी पकड़िए और राइटर को हम पैसे दे देते हैं मतलब ये है कि ये गारंटीड है मतलब ऐसा नहीं है कि राइटर एनओसी दे देगा तो पता पैसे का कहीं कोई जो है कोई रिस्क नहीं उठा
जो बात फेडरेशन के जरिए कहना चाह रहे हो अंजुम साहब ये देखिएगा और अश्विनी जी कि एनओसी देना कंपलसरी है इट इज नॉट दैट द राइटर कैन रिफ्यूज टू गिव एनओसी नो आफ्टर हिज पेमेंट हैज बीन मेड He has to give the NOC. Now that's true for all the affiliates. This is not for Writer Association itself. Chahe wo Fighter Association ho, DOPs की एसोसिएशन हो, उनको अगर प्रोड्यूसर कहता है तो उसका हक इतना है कि उसके रुपए दें और NOC वो दे गई। सो अश्नी जी का जो ये अश्नी का ये कहना है कि शायद राइटर NOC नहीं देगा, हम कहते हैं कॉन्ट्रैक्ट में ये बात डाली जाए कि NOC उसे देना पड़ेगा फेडरेशन के AGCs में, अगर पॉसिबल है तो, अगर पॉसिबल
This clearly says that this, there is an NOC already written into the contract because your money is protected. So exactly what you're saying, the same principle operates here, even what Chaturvedi Sahib is saying, that your money will not be blocked and your top line credit will not be blocked. But otherwise there's an NOC, you're giving an NOC saying these protect these two things and take an NOC.
Yeah, my name is Ritesh Sinha. I'm talking about this topic itself. We are talking at this point of time, we are talking on a little more simplistic level where I have a story, some producer is willing to produce it. But we suppose I'm talking about new age, which is happening, where I have worked on a story for 4 years in Europe and I have come to India to make the film. Now the thing is it's a complete concept with, it's a trilogy actually, which has a perhaps 150, 200 crore value in terms of box office. So the problem is, that when the whole thing has been developed at that level, when I'm presenting it to a producer, the challenge is that 4 years of hard work has to be seen from him at that level and he should not dilute it. So the what we are doing now is that we have decided to own the property, whatever we have developed, and we are telling the producer that if you want, you take the profit of the thing, but if it has to be remade as in a sequel or anything, the right of that property remains with us. That way we are able to have a creative control on that property. Now, what is happening in this is that the producer or the director producer may have an opinion that, you know, I have a buddy who always writes for me. So that's where, you know, we have to take a call in our contract that, yes, this is the concept. This is the format of the whole film. On our agreement, we can bring on board someone else. So that has to be incorporated in case the value of the project is very high. It's not a question of 8 lakh or 10 lakh, but suppose it's a big project, which to me, for 10 months I have been in India now, I have been very fearful because, you know, the respect for writers are not there, you know, in the hierarchy. Ashni knows me very well. Excuse me, Ashni, if you remember 2004, I was the one who spotted Chetan Bhagat in Hong Kong and brought him to India. We did an agreement together, if you remember. It was an extensive agreement, which Raju is now making that film.
Ritesh, please, let me...
So I'm just trying to clarify that fear of getting your hard work diluted vis-a-vis a third party has to be addressed very carefully.
At this stage, I don't think it is strategic to do that across the board.
So we have to incorporate that in the agreement itself.
No, that is a desirable clause which you will get advice from the legal cell that yes, how would you like to go about it? I'm saying that this basic contract is across the board even for 8 lakh.
All right. So it's a generalized version at this stage.
It is because these are the basic clauses which will operate across the board.
This is the minimum. You can go as far as you want. Anju. Subject to negotiation, Anju, whatever you'd like. But this is something that you present as a first time writer.
Atul needs a clarity.
In your case...
One second, please.
I'd like to answer his question, please. In your case is a bit different because you are not commissioned. You own the property. So that will be treated totally differently. Right?
Yeah, but Atul, even if you own the property, at some stage you will have to get into a contract.
But what he's basically saying is the IPR belongs to him. He's giving the specific right to make a film in a particular language to somebody else. So this is a completely different situation.
That is a different scenario. You can do that. Okay, on this particular point about this NOC business and about including other writers, but your fee and credit being protected, on this point, do you have some question or an answer, sir?
Hi, this is Sanjay Chhel, and out of my experience, I want to... consult you all or suggest something. See, normally what happens, story, screenplay and dialogues. Lot of time it happens, Robin is aware and Imtiaz and we all know about it. There are three writers, suppose. One is writing story, one is writing screenplay, one is writing dialogues. And after that, when we see the final title, that is written and directed by the director. Now that should be addressed because...
Yeah, okay, done. I know, we've
specifically, discussed this. Specifically
it will be addressed.
A. And second thing, when the promos start, when we don't get the credits, normally producers say that we want to give it, but these promos are made by music industry. Okay, so the choreographer will be there, lyricist will be there. I am nothing against them, but the writer's credit will not be there. Even the promo is 90 seconds, and most of the time producers 50% they agree that they should give, but they say it's with the HMV or TCS or whatever. So in that case, what is association is going to?
I'll tell you. See, the point is that about this publicity, there will be certain forums of publicity where we will have to negotiate. So what we will need to put down is some basic, again, non-negotiable forums, like the print, like posters. Okay. Outside of this, if it's a cassette or if it's a CD, as he says, made by the music company, that will have to be negotiated on a case-to-case basis, I think, because this there is still a question mark on that. That some basic publicity material has to carry your name. Beyond that, it's just, you can try. If you have the clout, put it down. Couple of contracts, I put it down.
As Sanjay said, we are dealing with this problem. We have written letter to all the associations, all the producers, all the music director, all the music companies and channels also, and radio station as well. We are dealing with it. Just be patient. Things will be nice. Definitely you will get your credit. 100%.
Sir, story, screenplay and dialogues. Tino ke liye equal fees kya barabar hai? Sab usse convinced hai.
Okay, we've had extensive discussions on whether the fees is equal or not equal. We had a large number of people who got together and we decided that we don't have a right to distinguish ki kaun kam kaam karta hai aur kaun zyada kaam karta hai. I mean, it would be a little unfair for us. Some of us are screenplay writers, some of us are story writers, some of us are dialogue writers. The story writer says, you know, the toughest thing is to come up with an idea. A screenplay and a dialogue does not compare to that. A screenplay writer says, you know what, I actually pan out the whole film. And a dialogue writer says, you know, usually they just come with basic scenarios and I'm actually the person who writes the film. So we don't want to get into an argument and a fight over who does how much work. We feel equal work, in a way this is equal work, and therefore equal fees, minimum equal fees for all these three sections.
This also specifies, by the way, that you cannot work for less. You define low budget. Define low budget. Give me a figure. 1.5 crore. You're telling me a man goes out to make a film of 1.5 crore and he doesn't have 9 lakh of rupees to pay for the script?
60 lakh films. 60 lakh films are being made now.
At the moment, what we are saying is this is what we've come up with. Now you tell me.
And 60
after due deliberation, no, 1 minute. After taking into account this point, this is an elementary point, we couldn't possibly have missed that.
Nobody is getting paid 3 lakhs on the film. Nobody, not even the director.
You decide. Because if you put in this clause of the budget,
a lot of films will not get made.
A lot of film will upgrade their writing budgets.
देखिए सुनिए, अभी ये स्ट्राइक के बाद हमने एक कोर कमेटी बनाई है, फेडरेशन की कोर कमेटी है, 22 एसोसिएशंस में से हमने 10 मेंबर चुने हैं, और प्रोड्यूसर की कोर कमेटी है, वो तीनों एसोसिएशंस जो हैं, चारों एसोसिएशन से उनके मेंबर आ रहे हैं, हम वो बैठ के जो भी मसले हमारे हैं, ये आपका मॉडल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट भी उसी में आएगा, उसी में डिस्कस पहले किया जाएगा, उसमें जो है सजेशंस आएंगे। कई बार आप भी कह रहे हैं कि 60 लाख की फिल्म है, 60 लाख में अगर वो 9-10 लाख रुपए दे देगा कैसे देगा, तो वहाँ पे ये मसले हल किए जाएंगे, वहीं से ये आउटकम निकलेगा जो दोनों पार्टियों को मानना पड़ेगा, ये ज्वाइंट वो होगा। तो इसमें मेरा ख्याल है कि 15-20 दिन या एक महीने में ये बात सॉल्व हो जाएगी।
नहीं नहीं चतुर्वेदी साहब, वो बात तो बिल्कुल ठीक है, यहाँ तो सिर्फ ये है कि अगर यह सहमति है तो एटलीस्ट ये हम लोग फेडरेशन के पास तो ले आए, यू नो, तो यहाँ एक एटलीस्ट एक थोड़ा सा एक सम एग्रीमेंट हैज टू बी देयर।
दिस 9 लाख इज द बेसिक मिनिमम दैट वी आर टॉकिंग अक्रॉस द बोर्ड। इफ समबडी इज सपोज टू इज लाइक द जेंटलमैन देयर हु वांट्स टू मेक अ फिल्म इन 60 लाख फॉर एग्जांपल, ही इज कम एंड अप्रोच मी टू राइट इट एंड आई लाइक टू राइट इट, आई कैन राइट इट फॉर फ्री इफ आई वांट।
या
If you I mean, in the, it's my individual right. I can write it for 50, I can write it for a lakh. I mean, look, I'm just trying to make this easier. I just want to understand.
Vinod, you have to see whether we can carry crowd on this one.
Hear me out.
Yeah. Because if we have these kind of situations possible, then in which case this contract has no value at all. Because everybody makes exceptions out of that. He's saying, no, he's my friend. Here we are saying is that if there is firstly nobody, but nobody will ride without a contract. That means the Federation actually will ensure that they and the Film Writers Association might even have the facility of spot checks. That if we discover that a writer is writing for that, we are well within our rights to write to them saying, please furnish a copy of the contract. To make sure that these clauses which this Federation has ensured, okay, have to be honored. So firstly, nobody writes without a contract. Low budget films, you tell me, first you told me low budget film is 1.5 crore. To me, 1.5 crore for 9 lakh is not a low budget film.
And he can afford to make those films without stars because he's himself, because his budget is 1 crore, so he can probably spend about 3-4 lakhs. But this will definitely finish those films completely because you are pushing them towards the star cast films. And it means the qualitative independent cinema will die.
No, I understand, but see, what our view here was, and this is a considered view of very senior professionals, including people like Vishal and others who are also producers here. Their view was that this itself is, this is not...
Because they are getting the corporate backing. I am also getting corporate
backing. 9 lakh is not a star cast film. A star cast film is 90 lakh, where the writer is paid 90 lakh. That's a star cast film. Which is what we should be aiming for. 9 lakh is not something which kills a non-star cast.
See, the film which is made in 1 crore or 1.5 crore cannot afford it. I am a producer also, director also, writer also. I can tell you it can simply not be made.
Yeah, you were saying there is a solution. Somebody give him a mic, please, right now. Because I want this recorded. Let's listen to what he's saying. Maybe there is a solution here.
A possibility is that the writer says, yes, I bill for 3 lakhs. And I give a discount and bring it down to 40,000.
You know what this means?
I don't know.
You know what this means? If you allow this, every producer will beat you down to 40%.
I really don't know.
What is the meaning of the contract? I'm sorry.
I just want to make a point about low budget films. It's a fairly considered option, especially because of the time now that digital has come in. Filmmaking, the cost has been reduced. My contention is that if the producer is saying, listen, I'm going to make a film in 60 lakhs, I can't pay you 4 lakhs, will he in contractual agreement then say that 10% to 15% of all profits after the realization of the film will belong to the writer? We're not allowing that right now, but I'm saying is that, because I didn't hear any producer or director stand up and say, you know what, my film is going to be low budget, I will not be able to pay you right now, but on contract I will sign so much percentage of the profits to you. You know, suddenly I have signed low budget contracts.
He's not talking about including that as a clause. He's talking about a certain approach that when low budget people come to you, it is merely that, okay, they want you to beat down your fees. It's not that they will give you a share of the profits. Yeah, sure. Okay, the lady there, please. Let's hear her out. Please give me your name also so we can record.
My name is Geeta Kamal. Ashwini, can you open your PowerPoint presentation, please? And go back right to the beginning. You mentioned something about 2 years and then a buyback clause. So if the rights are automatically going to revert to the writer, if the producer does not make the film within 1 year, why is there a question of buyback by the writer?
No, there were two options we said. We said what we discussed was that either it could be this, which might be difficult to pull off, or we said which seems more reasonable and attractive in the arrangement is that after the 2 year period is over, the writer gets 1 year grace period to buy it back at 50% of the cost.
But why should the writer buy back if the producer does not make the film?
No, see, these are basic options. This is something to negotiate with the producers. Firstly, today the fact that the producer has paid you 100%, assuming he has paid you 100% of your fee to write the script. Okay, if you can get the clause which says that if he agrees to saying yes in 2 years, if I don't make it, the script goes back to you. If he does not agree to this, we can work and try towards a second option. Remember, this is, you have been paid your full fee. This is an option after you've been paid your full fee, that you can have an option to buy it back at 50%. Okay, so you are anyways, you've got your 100%, but if you so choose and you're passionate and you want somebody else to make it, you have that option for 1 year, after 2 years, to buy it back.
The point, see, you need to remember, this is not an ideal contract. This is a contract which is posited against the situation in which we are at the moment. We need to work our way out of it. So I talked about a staggered way of going about it. In this, as a first step, today, let's say for the next 2 years, is this acceptable to you for the first 2 years? We need to get out of this situation.
Yeah. Anjum.
Right now you can't talk about, okay, naturally reverts to me and Copyright Act and global conventions and all, because you will get nowhere.
My name is Bobby Khan. I'm a scriptwriter. ये इंडियन स्क्रिप्ट राइटर्स कॉन्फ्रेंस हो रही है और राइटर एसोसिएशन है. इन्होंने कहा कि 3 लाख रुपए ज्यादा हैं डायलॉग्स के लिए. आई एम राइटिंग ए फिल्म. 1 लाख रुपए की वो शॉर्ट स्टोरी फिल्म बनती है जिसमें राइटर को 1 लाख रुपए दिए जाते हैं. उसमें डिवाइड कीजिए स्टोरी स्क्रीन पे डायलॉग. 6 ड्राफ्ट लिखता हूं मैं, 6 महीने काम करता हूं, मेरे हिस्से 33,000 रुपए आते हैं. आपको लगता है बॉम्बे में 33,000 रुपए में मैं अपने बच्चों को बीवी को रख सकता हूं?
What are you saying about this minimum fee that we are proposing?
क्या करेंगे आप? 100% मुझे लगता है कम है, इससे ज्यादा होना चाहिए. राइटर एसोसिएशन में राइटर के लिए बात की जा रही है, इसके खिलाफ जो लोग बोल रहे हैं वो गलत हैं.
9 lakh is minimum what we are projecting it.
Okay,
right now.
But do you have something to say? Anmol, you have something to say?
There are some fundamentals that we have to first understand. That a writer is not making a sofa set for a producer, that if nobody sat on it, then you can buy back that sofa set. A script is being written expressly to be made into a feature film. And if that film cannot be made by the producer, how, pray, you can say that I need to buy back that chair, you know, that I made for you? No, it's a script. It was for a particular purpose. That purpose was not brought forward by the producer. He could not organize it. Too bad. He'll have to lose it.
But sorry to, you can ask for it. This is a minimum requirement. If you choose to say, but today as a first-time writer, it may be slightly difficult for you to go to a producer and say, this is what it is for, you don't make the film. The script is mine and the money is mine. So that's why we're trying to take baby steps by saying, if this doesn't work, then I have an option to buy it back at 50%.
Second option will be always exercised.
Also, the thing is here that once this comes into play, most producers will not say that I'm not making it. They said, of course I'm making it. It's been 2 years, it's been 5 years, it's been 11 years.
Two years.
It. Yeah, so I'm saying, that's it. Now what we're doing is that we are sort of trying to prevent that. Okay, put 2 years. You may not want to buy it back because you received your full payment. But if you are able to sell it elsewhere, then here for negotiation purposes, we are saying that we will be able to offer you 50%. On the table when we go, Amol, you and I, maybe we'll start with zero.
It's your option.
But I'm saying, are we ready for this? I mean,
that option is his option, actually, not mine.
Across the board, not yours.
No, my option was that 2 years over, I got it back.
You do that, Amol. And you will be able to swing it because you've got Tare Zameepar behind you. Other people don't have that, so I'm saying...
No, it's not that. It's not that.
No. I'm saying in this option, in this...
See, what happens is work for hire situation will always reduce the artistic power of the writer.
But we are not, that's why I'm saying that the nature of this agreement is not work for hire. We're talking about royalties, we're talking about remake rights, prequel rights, so it's not. And we are saying that only when you give me the full money do I hereby consciously assign the rights to you. So it's not that the moment I sign the contract, all my rights are yours. That would be work for hire.
And even
it's
if
not you, a work for hire,
even if
discussed.
You do call it a work for hire, it is subject to the terms of this agreement. So if it is work for hire, it's not transferred to you till I get my money, subject to me obviously not being in default. Secondly, again, if you can, as a writer, say, yes, this is for 2 years and I have a right to get it back. And if it works for you, that's great. This is just a minimum start off for someone who's even probably never written a script. Yeah?
He might have written a poem when he was 7 years old. That makes him a writer. That's what I understand of writing.
In terms of negotiation, today,
you know,
if I'm a first-time writer and I go to a producer and say, okay, if you're not going to do this, I get to keep my full money plus my rights come back to me. That may be difficult to
say. But what about that corollary, which says that after 12 months of non-exploitation, it goes back to the writer?
Amol, you are talking about a practical implementation right now.
Yeah, we're talking practical.
We need to be able to push this through.
So the producer is always going to waive that right.
If we hassle on this, we might lose out on other more important rights. So at the moment I'm saying, given what we decided, that yes, of course, this is what we would like. But at even this much, you're getting nothing right now. In perpetuity, they belong to him, every single thing.
And
all we're talking about is 2 years later, I have a right to buy it back in case I'm able to find another producer who will pay me maybe 150%. So in which case I give 50 to him and I still earn 200%.
And Anjum, the 19-4 Amol, it basically says if you don't exploit. Now, exploit in terms of what? Today, if you've written the script, him talking to writers may be furthering the script. Him doing pre-production may be furthering it. So exploiting or using it could have different terms in different this thing.
Which is why we said, no, that at the end of 2 years, filming should have begun, right?
Exactly. So that's
first day of shooting should have happened in this 365 into 2. That is what we're talking about.
Yeah.
We are saying that the purpose of writing is to
film. We are saying that, but we are also saying that therefore now this is a midway solution here, that we get the chance to buy it back in 50%.
But how can I buy back what is mine?
Amol, you're raking it up again.
Okay, I'll keep quiet.
We went over this. Okay, Ashni, can you just put the points up one by one, please, so I can just run through it? Yeah? Are we going through with the minimum wage thing, that this is what we intend to take to producers? Then we have to see. If you think that 9 lakhs will go through, you might be sadly mistaken. But this is what we're going to fight for. This is what we are going to fight for, Sanjay. All of us cannot be part of the negotiating committee.
I'm not saying that. You are saying if you don't pull it off, minimum 3 to 4 crore today, make the 9 lakhs nothing. Minimum 12.
Where?
Okay, I understand. You go ahead.
I am
nine.
Saying we are going to fight for this. In case it turns out that it is going, if it is being sort of pushed down beyond reason, we will break off the negotiations and come back to you.
Anjum, we can categorize. We can
what categorize? I've just categorized.
No, we can low budget.
Categorize based on what? Budgets? Oh man, everybody is a low budget filmmaker. Yeah. Everybody makes low. When they want to negotiate with you, all their budgets are very low. Yeah.
Anjum,
we went over Anjum. That. It's very difficult to pinpoint.
Okay, Anjum, I just need to ask you one question. Has your group ensured that, you know, there will be not too much perennial unemployment, because all directors, producers might just say that, okay, instead of giving somebody 9 lakhs, we just train ourselves, few lakhs just...
They can do that now. If they can write themselves, they should write themselves. Who's saying no to that?
I mean, there is a possibility.
Have I ensured? What do you mean, have I ensured that? How will I
between,
ensure that?
No, as in like...
All I'm saying is that this is what... See, films have to be made.
Correct.
Scripts have to be written.
Correct.
Okay, and we are the ones who are going to be writing. Right. So who else will they go to? If they know that, oh, you are asking for 9, somebody else is asking, you're coming in 6, then they will go there. But if everybody is asking for 9 and that is the cost of getting a script written, then that is that. What is the choice that you have?
The way he was saying for low budget movies, can we have an option where a writer charges less than 9 lakhs for a low budget movie only after getting an NOC from the panelists of the Writers Association, saying that as per case basis, as this is a small movie, small budget movie.
See, this is why this gathering is beautiful. We never thought of that. Okay, despite 6 months of wrangling. Do you think this is a viable option? I'll have to just get back to the consultative group on this one. Because the possibility of corruption tends to increase. Right now, we are in the committee. 6 years later, I have no idea who will be in the committee. Okay. So do you want to have that? Do you feel that that's a viable option?
No.
Thank you for thinking of that, but...
can we have television?
The contract of television is still being constructed.
Yeah, that's
there is. There, all these clauses are there in television also. One thing I just want to add. See, this is for new writers, because I was till very recently a new writer. We want people to be hired on merit. We don't want people to be hired on cost cutting. No, you don't have to clap. What I'm saying is, we believe that there is an inclusive cost to making a film. If you want to be a producer, there are certain costs. And one of the costs is the minimum cost of a writer. If you don't think, if you want a professional writer and you're not willing to pay a minimum cost, you write it yourself. We are professionals, and every profession, every trade union has minimum wages. To say, oh, if you construct minimum wages, there will be unemployment, is the oldest, crappiest excuse given in the book. So unlike what Abbas said yesterday, yes, there's respect. We believe a minimum fees And then organizing on this method will only improve the merit, because it will increase the pressure on the producer to be responsible for the money he's paying. He will for once in his life read a script. Because he's paid 3 lakhs for it.
सबसे पहले बहुत पॉजिटिव कॉन्ट्रैक्ट है ये, उसके लिए मैं बधाई देना चाहता हूँ. सेकेंडली मैं ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि इसमें अगर एक वॉलेंटरी डिस्क्लोजर टाइप का कुछ क्लॉज ऐड हो फ्रॉम द राइटर साइड, तो वो शायद उन लोगों के लिए भी, सब लोगों के लिए भी हो सकता है जो छोटे बजट या फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट.
व्हाट इज वॉलंटरी डिस्क्लोजर, प्लीज एक्सप्लेन.
या जिस तरह से आपने मिनिमम वेजेस का क्लॉज बनाया वो हो डेफिनेटली, लेकिन एक राइटर की ओर से उसमें एक क्लॉज एडिशनल हो जिसको वॉलंटरी डिस्क्लोजर बोला जाए, जिसमें राइटर अगर चाहता है कि वो अंजुम जी के लिए एक फिल्म बनाना चाहता है और उसमें वो खाली 51,000 लेना चाहता है और वो भी किसी बच्चे को डोनेट करना चाहता है, तो उसकी आजादी राइटर को होना चाहिए.
वो नहीं है इसमें. नहीं है.
नहीं
इसमें नहीं है. यू कांट राइट बिलो 9.
नहीं नहीं, मैं बिलो 9 की बात नहीं कर रहा हूँ.
नो यू कांट, बिलो 9 इज 51,000.
नहीं नहीं,
यू कांट राइट. नो सीरियसली, I'm telling you this will be binding. No, no, I'm being serious. I'm not just trying to be facetious.
मैं भी seriously बात कर रहा हूँ सर, कि 9 लाख मुझे भी सबको अच्छे लगते हैं, लेकिन साथ में किसी एक राइटर का वो राइट किल नहीं होना चाहिए कि वो एक अगर छोटे बजट की फिल्म किसी के साथ बनाना चाहता है तो. बस मेरा इतना गुजारिश.
देखिए ये 9 लाख रुपए का प्रपोजल है, ये आपका हमारे ये फेडरेशन में आएगा. फेडरेशन की कोर कमेटी, प्रोड्यूसर की कोर कमेटी से डिसाइड करेगी. वो जो आप कह रहे हैं लो बजट और लो उसका, वो भी प्रोड्यूसर वहाँ पर ऐसे तो प्रोड्यूसर वहाँ से मांगेगा ही कि साहब 1 करोड़ की फिल्म का क्या करेंगे. तो वहाँ पे कोर कमेटी, दोनों फेडरेशन और प्रोड्यूसर्स बॉडी की कोर कमेटी वहाँ डिसाइड करेगी. यहाँ से ही 9 लाख रुपए का मिनिमम प्रपोजल है. 9 लाख रुपए इन्होंने कहा है, आप 90 लाख लीजिए ना, कौन मना करता है. हमारी 22 एसोसिएशन में मिनिमम वेजे रखे गए हैं, चाहे साउंड रिकॉर्डर्स है, चाहे कैमरामैन है, चाहे फाइट मास्टर है. इतना क्योंकि एब्सेंस ऑफ कॉन्ट्रैक्ट में उतना ये रखा गया कि आपको इतना देना पड़ेगा. लेकिन हम ये थोड़ी अशोक मेहता हैं, अगर हमने 10,000 रुपये पर डे कैमरामैन का रखा है तो अशोक मेहता तो 2 लाख रुपये लेते हैं, लें. लेकिन अगर कॉन्ट्रैक्ट नहीं है तो मिनिमम वेजेस गिने जाते हैं. इसलिए ये यहाँ से प्रपोजल जाएगा, वहाँ कोर कमेटी में पास हो जाएगा. लेकिन यहाँ पे ये इसमें नहीं है कि 9 लाख रुपये 12 होने चाहिए, 15 होने चाहिए. मैंने सुन रहा था आप 9 लाख रुपए रखें, आप लीजिए ना, 20 लाख लीजिए, 25 लाख लीजिए, कोई मना नहीं करता.
और दूसरी अहम बात मैं कह दूं कि ये जो आप लोगों ने इलेक्ट की हुई कमेटी है, 50 साल की हिस्ट्री में एसोसिएशन की पहली दफ़ा ये हो रहा है कि हम एक कॉन्ट्रैक्ट मॉडल बना रहे हैं, हम उसको नेगोशिएट करना चाहते हैं, हम प्रोड्यूसर बॉडी के साथ बैठना चाहते हैं. वो एक अहम स्टेप है जो ये ली जा रही है इस वक्त. तो हमको लगता है ये राइटरों की महफिल है और राइटर्स की महफिल में उस स्टेप की सराहना करनी चाहिए और आपको जितना जल्दी हो उसके साथ सहमति दिखानी चाहिए मुझे.
इफ यू आर थ्रू विद द टोटल पेमेंट देन लेट्स मूव टू द शेड्यूल ऑफ पेमेंट्स. आर यू राजश्री, वांट टू से समथिंग अबाउट द मिनिमम पेमेंट? व्हाट इज इट दैट यू वांट टू से? इज देयर अ वे आउट? इज दैट व्हाट यू आर लुकिंग फॉर? Oh man, everyone's looking for a way out of this one. I mean, you're all becoming producers or what?
I wanted to suggest that if a producer, a low-budget producer, can give you a percentage if he does not give you the 9 lakhs, would that be possible?
No, that wouldn't be possible in this particular case, no, because there is no accountability on that. Absolutely none. He will say, I am in fact made a loss, come on, give me some money. You know? So but it becomes very difficult, no, because for a writer, it becomes very difficult. What will you do? You'll come running to the association every other day, saying, okay, he hasn't paid this, he hasn't, what can we do? Because it's a grey area. I mean, this murky accounting taking place. Don't go by the 4 or 5 big producers. Okay, so it was very difficult to go through. So that's why we rejected that possibility. It was most certainly the most reasonable and scientific possibility, but absolutely impossible to implement. Thanks, Rajashree. Okay, shall we move on to the schedule of payments, please? Yes. Thank you very much. This is for a composite script, right? There are separate figures which will operate when we have specialized contracts for story and for screenplay and for dialogue, etc. But the, what you need to also look at is the underlying principle here. Okay, tell me, do you have any views on this? Only if you have a view which is a problem. You have a view? Okay, let me hear the first view before deciding whether we should continue with this question taking on this point.
My name is Mahesh. I have a practical problem in this thing. How do you decide which is the what draft, when you narrate or when you give it to a, should a draft which is agreed upon in changes characters, should I come back to the Film Writers Association and register?
No, I'll answer my first that draft, before you even second. Complete the question. Yeah. Because there will be a definition attached as an annexure to every agreement. And that definition will be worked out by the Film Writers Association of what you mean by story, what you mean by screenplay and dialogue, and what does a draft constitute. Okay? What we have also included is that when you give your first draft, you get a written stamp on that from the producer's office, number one, so that the date is specified. Number two, there is a turnaround time that the producer gets, and he has to give you written comments on that one. So it can't be merely verbally that he tells you this and then he says, oh, you didn't do what I had asked you to do, in which case I can't accept the second draft. So there are written comments. So in case of a dispute, that becomes the second draft. And the third. So you see, all this will also put pressure on you, and it will certainly put a lot of pressure on the producers who are going to tear their hair out saying, why should I give written? Because we don't have that system. We don't have that culture of, you know, whatever relationship in the between producer and writer. But yes, it will be governed by those things. Any other issue on the payment? I mean, on the schedule of payment? Yusuf has something to say. I'll come to you. One second. Here, Jitin to Yusuf Merchant, please.
Just specifically about the last payment within 1 month of first day of shooting. Yes. Supposing they don't start shooting for 2 years.
Yeah.
Then you'd not get that 15%.
Hello? You get the script back and you get the 15%. Because that's the producer's default. It comes under producer's default, Yusuf.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you get your full payment.
And supposing
and you get,
they start,
you get the option.
Yeah, and
to
buy
they
the start shooting
back.
After 720 days. That means you'll get your 15% after 1 month after that.
That is that you can't.
Can't you have within 1 month of first day of shooting, or you know, 6 months at least of approval of final script with dialogues? One of those kind of things?
Yusuf, you also need to be able to give some to get some. You know, in this case, and today.
Yeah, but if you ask for a little more, you may get a little less, but you may get a little less than what you want.
Today's condition is that some people get about 40 to 50% on the day of release. Here we are talking about 1 month after the first day of principal photography. 15%. Yusuf, this seems reasonable to me. 15%, Yusuf. We are just leaving 15% to negotiation. I mean. Because see, the point also is that you need to have good faith. You also need, that's why we have Ashni. That's why on our board, we have producers, people who turn producers. Amol is a producer, Vishal is a producer, there's several of these people are producers. So we've tried to take both parties into account, okay, to work this out. Okay, do you have something to say about that? The gentleman in the blue cap there.
Okay, what we are not addressing is something which is fully written before it comes to the producer. This is assuming that he is asking me to write something.
Okay.
Or something completely
I'll
written.
I'll answer it before you finish.
Yeah.
Okay. When it comes fully written as a full script with dialogue to the producer, if he accepts it as the final draft saying that there is no rewrite required, what you get is 85%. If he says this is the first draft actually, okay, and on this, so I accept the screenplay as the final thing, but I want the dialogue to be rewritten, then what you get is 60%.
So it's specified in the contract.
And if he says that I want the screenplay also to be rewritten here, in which case it gets treated as a first draft of the screenplay, so which means you get 35%.
So the contract specifies that?
The contract implies that in
no,
this case. Okay, we'll specify
that.
I'll put a paragraph.
I think we should specify it.
Okay, thank you very much. What was your name?
Abhigyan.
But that's
oh, this Abhigyan, I can't see your face.
Anjum, that would be more like a script acquisition agreement or a story acquisition agreement.
Yeah, but in what? Therefore, he's asking. Yeah, so therefore, yeah. How much? Yeah. So okay. So we can put that paragraph in there. Okay.
We need to specify what happens before the signing amount, because mostly a signing amount is given after the story is approved. So how does it work here?
In this case, you have the prerogative to say no. I will not give you a story. Supposing they give you a concept and say, sorry, the contract only comes into operation after you write the story. You are at liberty to say no. And everybody else in this room is at liberty to say no.
No, but suppose it's feel, my no, story. It's my
if,
story.
Then
and
in which case, if they accept the story and give you a contract, in which case you get 30%. You get 30%.
Right. No, I can't distinguish between the 20 and the 10%, the first two things. What is the signing agreement and what is on approval of story?
Signing agreement
I believe
is when
that
you
they have liked the story to have signed me on.
No. Many times they like the concept or they give you the concept, saying that, okay, this is what we'd like you to work on. In which case, they're signing you and asking you to do their work, so they have to pay you 20%.
So in that case, we'll need to specify
what
a concept would also be. As in,
those things which she said, no, Ashni said initially, that all those terms...
It'll be covered in the definition and you'll probably have that as an attachment to the agreement saying you're going to write a story based on this concept.
Yeah. Right. What is the concept? What is the story? All that we will specify and we will circulate widely to all you people.
Thanks so much.
Okay, this is the definition.
Thanks so much.
Anjali Agarwal, okay. This is on the thing that we are giving a concept to the producer and they are signing us. Yeah. What if I have a bound script and I'm circulating it to the producers and it's with various producers and somebody just makes a movie out of it and they don't pay me and they recognize me that this is the script I gave them? Then, a lot of the times we are circulating scripts around.
What you're talking about is copyright violation.
Commissioning. This is commissioning.
No, what you're talking about is theft. Is that what you're referring to?
The thing is, how do I protect my bound script from being plagiarized?
You basically first have to...
Are you a member of the Film Writers Association?
No.
You aren't. Okay, number one. Okay, for all of you who are not. Become a member of the Film Writers Association. Number two, whatever it is that you write, get it registered and stamped. Okay.
Also,
that when there is a dispute, that becomes the evidence that it is yours.
And as a precaution, you should sign a confidentiality agreement or a non-disclosure agreement,
okay.
Which will acknowledge your rights on it.
What if I've reached the 15%, last 15% state, and I've given my final draft, and they call a script doctor, and they make another draft, and they base the shooting on that draft, and the script is unrecognizable. They say, we have paid you money, we've paid you your money, and we'll give you credit. But what if the script is unrecognizable now from what I initially wrote?
Chances are you're probably going to say that you don't want a credit.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. So there is a clause, by the way, which we forgot to actually mention. There is a clause of withdrawal.
Hello. देखिए अगर आप member नहीं हैं, अगर आप Film Writers Association की member नहीं हैं, तो मतलब ये है कि ना हम इस सवाल का जवाब देने के लिए बाध्य हैं, ना ये सवाल पूछिए. नहीं आप member पहले बन जाइए, पहले आप हमसे कह रही हैं हमारी सुरक्षा का क्या होगा, हमारा ये क्या होगा, पहले आप हमारी तो बनिए. फिर हम देंगे ना पूरी सुरक्षा. हाँ आप पहले से ही पूछ रही हैं. यस
ओके ओके
पहले हमारी बनी
है. फाइन गुड एक्सीलेंट. आई एम ग्लैड यू अप्रूव. द पॉइंट ऑफ द मैटर इज दैट यस व्हाइल मिस्टर चतुर्वेदी इज एब्सोल्युटली राइट इट इज ट्रू दैट अ लॉट ऑफ अस हैव नॉट बिकम मेंबर्स येट. आई स्पोक विद अनुराग बासु. आई मीन वन ऑफ द बेटर नोन राइटर डायरेक्टर्स इन दिस कंट्री. ही इज नॉट येट अ मेंबर. He said, immediately, as soon as I return from my shoot from Maldives, I will become a member. Because what will happen eventually, Anjali, is not what will happen, which exists actually, but what will be implemented, is that unless you are a card-holding member of the Film Writers Association, you cannot write for any producer. Point is only to encourage all of you and to say that at some stage, this will become sort of, a cause for action. Okay, can we move on, please, now? Yeah, thank you very much. Yeah, okay, this... Assigning it and in case, as he said, any prequel sequel is made, after your monetary transaction has taken place, he has to specify this. Is that okay? Fine, let's move. Ashni, everybody is moving towards lunch, so we need to move this quickly now.
This is basically...
Okay, have you understood producer's default and writer's default? Is that your stomach speaking or is that your brain speaking? Okay. Yeah, okay. Moral rights, she explained. Arshad, do you have a question about credit?
Where exactly does the writer get his credit?
Okay.
Like in Hollywood, it's the second last credit.
No, understood. We should specify that. We will specify.
Okay.
Sorry.
Yeah.
It was there in the original minutes, but we have not put it into this thing. It will be done.
Yeah,
and I'm glad this is being recorded.
Does the director also get credit along with the writer, if that is what he specifies, if he insists on that?
Here, this is an issue. This means that technically the producer has agreed to hire the director as the second writer. In which case,
About interferences.
Interference means that he is the one who does maybe one line of rewriting and he wants second credit.
Huh.
In this particular case, I don't think you can prevent that. Unless you are a senior enough writer or you are a khadus person like me who says, no, sorry, no one else gets credit until I write down, I give a no objection. But as it stands, yes, the producer has the prerogative to give any other person credit that he wants to give, provided your credit positioning is protected.
Just like we register our scripts, can we also register our contracts with the association?
Well, and the can point we is, yeah.
also
yes,
can
you
we
can. Yes.
Publish those yes. in the Yes. The Journal of the Association, yes. So everyone knows.
Yes, yes, yes.
First of all, I think that will be an issue because there will be a breach of confidentiality. I don't think you will be allowed by the producers to do that because these are confidential terms between two parties.
No, that you can. But if they agree, the point is if you intend to do that, then you have to specify that in this, that I am at liberty to register this with the association. See, WGA does that.
WGA does that because
things are much more transparent.
So then everyone knows if it's published in the journal of the association, there will be a journal.
But what would you publish? The entire contract?
Not the contract. So-and-so has a contract with so-and-so to make a film. You know, that's it.
That, yes. Okay, to be considered, please. I'm glad it's being recorded.
In IFTA, whatever the name is, if I'm doing a film with a producer, I pay a certain amount in the association, and so in the future, if suppose I have any kind of whatever the issue, then the association gets involved. So if we have a fees, certain nominal fees, I'm not saying big fees, if I'm doing a film with a producer, I pay a certain amount, and then, that film is registered with the association, then it is it can be helpful, That is with other associations, you can check it out.
Okay, I'll check it out.
This is a fantastic template in case you're working with a producer as a writer. In a lot of cases, first-time writers are working with directors. So you're going to a director and you're saying, I'm a writer, I want to write for you. And he says, great, well, I have an idea or I have a concept and I'd like for you to develop it. The concept's mine, the story is mine. So what are we talking in terms of copyrights, other rights
that question. See, the point here is that this was also discussed. Now, you will have to have a separate letter transacted between you and the director, firstly, which honors this. That means the director is bound, by this. That the day he gets a producer, this has to go through. Otherwise, the copyright of the screenplay doesn't transfer.
But Anju, so that means, one sec, sorry. Today, if you're doing this deal, would the director be paying you? Okay, so as far as you're really concerned, vis-a-vis you and him, the rights are transferring to him with the understanding that he is going to get a producer and do X, Y, Z. His rights with the producer will be limited only to the extent that you give him the rights. So tomorrow, if your agreement with the director says, see, he's going to pay you provided you transfer the rights to him. Otherwise, he's not going to pay you. Then there's not going to be a contract. So when you do get into that contract, it's going to be a deal where he owns the rights. And he will find a producer within XYZ time, provided he does all this. Then you don't need to have a direct contract with the producer. What you will say is when he assigns this contract, whoever he assigns it will adhere to these terms. So today, with the director, if you said the remake rights are mine, the director cannot transfer remake rights to producer because he doesn't have them to give. But at the same time, with the understanding that whoever he transfers it to will give you the same credit, will give you the payment, will give you everything. So there will be an assignment letter that's been done between the three of you where the director's assigning your rights or this agreement to the producer. But as far as you're concerned, he's your producer for now.
Yeah, this is trying to work out some letter which at least includes these basic principles.
Sir, suppose there's a scenario that I become a co-writer of a film and I don't have a... I have a main writer who had made like 40% of the film. Producer is not happy with that. Now I am brought on the board. Now I make the film. I say that it was a bad film. And I convert it into a very good film. Okay, I have worked hard on it as a co-writer. But when the film is released, the main writer's name comes first and then my name comes. So don't you think that's an injustice to me?
No, it's not injustice at all. That's how it goes. Because it's first come, first hired, first credited basis. Unless you can arrive at an understanding with the main writer, as you're saying, or the first writer, and he issues a no objection saying, I completely respect your thing, and I will make sure that I get second credit. Otherwise, if he's hired first, across the board.
So the work that he did was not good.
He writes 10%, you write 90%, you get second credit. Moral right was done, it was explained. What is your problem with moral right?
Can we not make it the same way as it is in publishing, which is more clear? Which is that the moral right remains with the author in perpetuity.
What else are we saying here? Abhigyan?
The contract says it.
It says it in perpetuity.
You read that template, that frame which said that except for moral rights. That means it's yours completely.
reserved for perpetuity.
This is only for the purpose of presentation. We've said except moral rights. The agreement details out saying the author retains moral rights.
In perpetuity.
Credits में जो यहाँ पे लिखा है posters, teasers, trailers. पर आज के मीडिया एज में क्रेडिट्स वहाँ पर भी बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट माने जाते हैं जब फिल्म का प्रमोशन होता है सैटेलाइट प्रमोशन अवार्ड फंक्शंस में नाम लिए जाते हैं हर जगह पे राइटर एब्सेंट होता है मोस्ट ऑफ द
आई विल आंसर योर क्वेश्चन या आई नो व्हाट यू सेइंग मेरा ये कहना है कि भैया वी आर गोइंग टू नेगोशिएट टू मेक श्योर दैट एवरीवेयर यू नो व्हाट द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट सेज वेयरएवर द डायरेक्टर्स नेम इज मेंशनड द राइटर्स नेम विल बी मेंशनड Because this is what, don't clap, please. Don't clap. Thank you. Accept it. Yeah. So the fact is that this is what we are saying. Now the point is, it may not be easy to control all those media because the producer says that I don't have control over it. Maybe it is segmented, the whole publicity, you know, prerogatives. In which case, we may have to specify some basic media on which it is necessarily carried, and on others, they will endeavor, as the legal term is.
After writing 40% of the script, yes. If the producer says that I would like to change the writer, so in that case, would the writer get the credits?
Yes.
In the film?
We must listen because we did say that there is a producer's default and there is a writer's default. If it is the writer's default, then in which case the producer has the prerogative to not give you credit. But if it is the producer's default, okay, and he says, okay, I don't want you to write further or I'm engaging somebody else and you stop your work or for whatever reason it is that he doesn't want you to work further, your money and your credit is protected in the event of a producer's default.
I'll tell you what is false termination, which is that you tell that the film is terminated and then you go on and make the film and you don't give credit to the person.
Abhigyan, don't you feel that is covered?
No, how is it covered?
No,
how
what are you saying again?
If a writer is told that the film is terminated, it's not happening, and then the producer goes ahead and actually makes that film.
What we can provide for is basically that if it's abandoned at any given point,
yes,
you will get a right of first refusal to render your services again if at any point the film commences.
Yeah, you must add that.
Yeah.
Because it's already happened once.
Yeah.
And thanks. Different name, you just make the film and then the rights are not given. The name, credit, nothing is given.
Right. Thank you. Okay, then. Dispute. Do you have any problem with it coming to the Film Writers Association? Yeah? No? Right. Thank you. Okay, then? Dispute. Do you have any problem with it coming to the Film Writers Association? Yeah? No? Would you rather that the companies, arbitrators, unilaterally handle it? I have no problem if you want that. Do you? No. Right? Okay. Thank you.
ये जहाँ भी आपका dispute होगा, वहाँ पे मैं ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि जो हमारी सारी associations हैं, जब ये मामला प्रोड्यूसरों से नहीं बन पाता वो दो नोटिस तीन नोटिस देते हैं उसके बाद जो बैठक होती है फेडरेशन में होती है फेडरेशन में मामला लाया जाता है और फेडरेशन तब जो है फेडरेशन अपना फैसला सुनाती है उस प्रोड्यूसर को बुलाती है और जो है उस राइटर को जो भी है वहाँ पे टेक्नीशियन को बुलाया जाता है और जब वो भी मामला नहीं होता तो ज्वाइंट डिस्प्यूट में हम प्रोड्यूसर फेडरेशन और वो प्रोड्यूसर जो डिफॉल्टर है और वो राइटर वहाँ बैठ के जो फाइनल होता है वो दोनों पे बाइंडिंग होता है इसलिए यहाँ पे ये जो प्रोड्यूसर लिखा हुआ है यहाँ पे ये फेडरेशन होना चाहिए
ओके दिस इज द आर्बिट्रेशन थिंग आई मीन व्हिच इज कवर्ड बाय द एक्ट दैट इन केस द आइदर पार्टी इज नॉट हैप्पी विद द एसोसिएशन्स डिसीजन दे आर यू नो एट लिबर्टी टू अपॉइंट आर्बिट्रेटर्स इज दैट ओके डू हैव प्रॉब्लम विद आर्बिट्रेशन
Yeah, we have this time schedule whether within 15 days the rectification and it's also there within the time clause stuff with something is indisposed. Do we have something to protect that?
We have a definition of incapacity where we've said about 30 days. So, provided if he cannot render his services for a consecutive period of 30 days, only after 30 days can the producer terminate. But for those 30 days, they cannot, and it's not even considered his default or breach.
And in that also, you see, actually in reality, what may happen is that if you're really doing a good job and you have fallen ill, unless there is really a time imperative on his end, in which case he might apologize and say, listen, pal, I have to take on somebody else. Otherwise, he's likely to wait if you're doing good work. So it's not that he will use this as an excuse to terminate it. They're not sort of waiting to do that. We're going ahead with a very constructive attitude that they want you to write for them and vice versa. Yeah. So I think that about completes it. Is there any other question before we close this?
I'm talking about exclusions, which would be consultancy, assistants,
Where does that fit in into all of this?
Meaning you want a separate contract for consultancy?
No, I'm not asking for a separate contract.
Then?
If I just come to you as a consultant,
yes.
Am I bound by all these laws?
No, you're not.
Okay. So how
only
will
if you are a co-writer or a writer.
That is not, you know, it's not misused. How will you assure that?
Give me an example.
No, I could just call you a consultant and make you write and pay you less.
You're writing?
Yes. I'm talking about writing, dialogue, whatever.
Do you have something to say here? He says, what if they use a way out by actually, they've hired a writer, okay? And he's done some work. Now they want to hire a co-writer. Same terms ought to operate with that, but they don't call him a co-writer. What they do is they call him a consultant or a script doctor or somebody and get him actually to do the whole rewrite. And because he's desperate, he does that.
No,
he
but
doesn't
if you
get credit. No. He gets credit because he's quite happy to take a doctor's script doctor.
No,
doctor's.
It could be valid also. There could be a bouncing board.
No, he's saying that it might lead... would this lead to large scale?
No, but the fact is today, as me being the first writer, I'm anyways open to another co-writer being there so long as he gets a second.
No,
credit.
So if I get a bouncing board while I write myself, is that bouncing board a writer or somebody who gets a title first?
He will only get a second title, right?
If he's getting
a consultant title, it doesn't matter to you if that's a separate title.
No,
it doesn't matter to him. Supposing he's the one who's engaged as a consultant, but actually as a writer, effectively. But they say, we will call you a consultant and we'll give you 2.5 lakh of rupees.
Basically,
you
I'm
do
talking
the complete
about
rewrite for us. So in which case, that person's actually a writer, except that he's just avoiding all the clauses in this contract.
He chooses not
to accept the contract.
Then it comes down to one simple, I think. Yeah. This is open. I think at somewhere, like we said, you have to say no. The person who's been hired as a consultant, if you have been hired as a consultant and they're making you write, you say, excuse me, you hired me as a consultant, why are you making me write?
No. I'm talking about...
But he's willing to do it, no? So don't do it. Yeah, but... Listen. There's a consultant who's getting less, right, to do something that we can't control.
It's to be considered.
Yeah.
See, but that way you can get five consultants. You can just get anybody, pay them money and make them write without any credit.
To which the co-writer is agreeing because he's willing to take a lower price and doing it as a consultant.
To which you are agreeing. You're saying, I'm desperate. So, okay, call me whatever you want, but just give me my 2 lakh of rupees. I will write the complete script for you.
No, that's right.
So that may be a loophole. No, you're right. We may have to specify in which case, what is the definition of a consultant?
We can define those terms. Yeah. The consultant definition would be there in the contract. The co-writer, the definition...
Here you're out. She's answering you.
Yeah, the definition for the consultant would be there in the contract, along with the main writer and the co-writer.
We might
so
have to do that.
You have definitions which will spell out everything in the contract.
You're right. Thank you for bringing this up, because this again had eluded us. Because we'll need to define that, when does a consultant actually get defined as a writer? In which case, again, all these clauses come into play. Yeah. So that, plus the fact is that we also get things registered at the association. So for the disputes committee, there is also evidence that this was registered in this person's name. So we'll have to work around that. But thanks for that.
I'm Krishna Shah. I'm a current member of the Writers Guild of America. And I've sat on many negotiation committee for the Writers Guild of America. And when they were fighting with the MPAA, I want to make this one comment, that your contract is so much more powerful than Writers Guild contract in America.
Don't clap, that scares us.
No,
if they've not been able to pull it off, how do you expect us to pull it off? No.
I think that you have a gift is a federation. Federation will protect you, which we do not have in America. ISTA or NASDAQ, who have nothing to do with writers, nothing to do with actors, nothing to do with directors. We are left alone. So that's why whenever they want to screw us, they do screw us. Right now, even the writers in America does that have a contract with the reality show writers? They do not have a contract with the animation writers. It is very limited. What you have accomplished, it just takes my breath away. And I wish you, I congratulate you and wish you all the luck.
Thank you. I would like is a huge round of applause for the Federation. Because they are on my marks. Because he is absolutely right. In this respect, our sort of advantage is unique. And we have, I mean, Imtiaz later on will regale you with stories of how actually productions have been called to a halt because the Federation decided that this was unjust.
Well, here are my compliments that you're doing such a good thing, but this question goes out to the lawyers because FWA is a trade union, basically. The registered copies, the stamp and all which you put and you register the scripts, unfortunately you don't have a scanning facility where you can keep it in archives, but whatever copy which goes back to the writer, how much value does it hold for copyright infringements in the court of law?
Is it the Writers Association, the way you register it?
Yeah.
But the Writers Association really doesn't talk about accuracy of the script. It really talks about the date of registration
exactly.
And who's registered it first.
The whole purpose of registering it with the association is
no,
to...
No, you register it in Delhi. I mean,
I'm saying,
she'll be able to help.
So that's an additional strip which every writer should do.
That's absolutely an additional
not,
one. Yeah.
If you want, yes, all we are saying here is that this is not saying that you are the author of this. It says that on this particular date, you registered it in your name. Okay, it's like sending a self-addressed envelope to yourself and not opening, which is admissible in a court of law. That on this particular date, at least I had written this. So if somebody else registers the script after that date or doesn't register it at all, then the court of law, well, the precedent has been that it has accepted this as the authorship.
Okay.
See, the bylaw of the association very clearly states the registration should not be construed as copyright registration. So in a case of a dispute between writers to writer and a dispute between writer to producer, the register script of FWA comes handy. Now, in a court of law also, some of our cases which you have referred, our registered scripts has been recognized, but that's for the courts to decide. Legally speaking, as my friend Atul tells me, and Roni tells me, and Ashni tells me, it is better to get your script registered at the copyright board also. And Writer Association is looking into that also, okay, all those writers who need that extra protection maybe in due course of time will be provided.
I would request to disperse this particular information to all the writers.
We will do that. Yeah. We will do that. No, okay. We are moving into that area.
If you read
the bylaws, you read the constitution.
Every
it's written
gets,
over
it. It specifies that very clearly.
In the constitution, very clearly written. In the bylaws, very clearly written, which we hand over when you become a member to everybody.
Yeah, hi, I'm Abed. And I have one question. What if the producer starts shooting the movie within a month of the final draft and then he stalls the shoot for say 2 years? So technically he has started the shoot. So in that case, do we get a...
No, nothing, zero. This operates then. In that
it's gone.
It's gone. Okay. Unless he doesn't want, he has no intention of making it, and if you go and offer it to him, they're saying, I'll buy it back from you for 50%. He might say, very good. If he doesn't want to make it, then there's a good chance that he might say, okay, take it.
Okay.
Yeah, but if he doesn't, if he wants to recover 50% of the money, he might say, okay, fine, go ahead. So, but if he intends to make it, then he will obviously retain it.
Anju.
Or if he's being cussed, you can't help it.
Anju? Yes, sir. देखिए, आप लोग ये काम कर रहे हैं और एसोसिएशन आपको लुक आफ्टर करेगी नहीं तो फेडरेशन तो 21 एसोसिएशन आपके अलावा आपके पीछे खड़ी रहेंगे ये मैं आपको एश्योरेंस दे रहा हूँ फेडरेशन पूरी तरह आपके साथ है यस ये आप अपने आप को तरह ना समझिए आपके राइट्स उनकी हिफाजत की जाएगी आपकी एसोसिएशन तो है ही है नहीं तो हम 21 आदमी और आपके पीछे खड़े हो जाएंगे देखें भैया प्रोड्यूसर कब तक नहीं मानता है थैंक यू